have you in your today's session.
Yes. Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah. Can you start the session after?
Yeah, fine.
Yeah. So can you operate the PPTs from your end?
Yes, fine.
Sure.
Yes, can you see this? Can you see the screen?
Little bit louder, Aftab.
Yeah, fine. Guys, can you see the screen?
Yeah.
Okay, fine. So I wholeheartedly thank the Dayana Sagar College of Arts and Sciences and Commerce, Department of Management Studies, for providing this opportunity to share my experience. So what all I had through these years in after joining Dayana Sagar. So I'm covering the topics today, like an overview of B2 sales, the hurdles crossed to be here today. Okay, fine. Before starting about my company and what I have faced, the like learning skills or whatever maybe in the company, I'll start with the college life. Basically, like you all guys, I have come as a professional, I can say after completing a BCom, without having a clue for a future, I just came and joined the Dayana Sagar basically. So after that, whatever the guidance from the lecturers or whatever the activities they have conducted, so I bound myself in that way that I have got placed in a very good company. So basically what I learned is you have to be taking part in every each and activity in your life. Basically, it might be a presentation going on, so you have to lead the presentation, or any activity it conducted, you have to lead that. So no one will give the opportunity until you utilize and make it for yourself. So even we had fun learning everything. Keeping apart is you have to take the initiative in everything. So that will lead into the success, according to me. So basically I'm working in Keyence India Private Limited. So our company has started in since 1974. It is operating in from Japan. So we are an innovative leader in development of manufacturing, industrial automation and inspection equipment in the world. Yeah, our product consists of code readers, laser markers, machine vision systems, microscopes and sensors and static elevators, further helping for the manufacturing industry basically. So this is our corporate office in Java that is located in Osaka, Japan. And just for it, we have a global sales from it, it's around $5 billion. And worldwide employees, we have around 9,000. So our offices, we have network of global network of 220 offices in around presence of 46 countries. And we have 2,50,000 plus clients. And the products featuring 70% that are industry first technology. So we are the world's top most innovative companies from 2011 to 2019, the top 100 in the Forbes. So our company is basically very famous for direct selling. So we have a direct selling network. So we have normally Keyence and adoption and after sales support basically. So I can say we have rejected this wholesaler or retailer anything, and direct network will be helping you in cutting the many of the cost and building your brand value as well. So I'll just start with in the placements basically. So it was a technical engineer job basically. So it's a technical sales. Basically, you have to sell the technical equipments microscopes or something. So basically, I'm from a complete commerce background. So I've done BCom in finance and MBA in core finance as well. So it was really tough for me to opt for this job, getting the technical knowledge. It's technical means, completely science related. So it was very difficult for me to opt that. So our company is like having a very best training in class, I can say. So extensive training, classroom instruction on our products and their application and the relevant industries. So 2 months rigorous training was given to me as like for the whole the batch was placed almost like around like 9 to 10 candidates were placed from Dhanand Sagar itself. So I'm proudly I can say we are like having the majority hold in our company. Like 8 to 9 members have been placed from our college itself. So hands-on training led by experienced application engineer, sales directors. Basically, the general manager or like a director of a company will be going to train you each and individual concept. So what is the thing? How to operate? How to work? Everything is taught in the training. So collaborative learning with a peer interaction. So normally, what the see experienced persons are there, or like a you know who are the currently working in Keynes, we have given the collaborative learning with them as well. So product demonstrations, role plays, like normally this is one of the key point I can say of a company. Six product demonstration and role plays. So role plays will help you a lot in you know cracking the interviews as well. In most of the interviews, you'll be getting a role plays. So you have to be a salesperson, and you know the interviewer will be a your customer. So you have to do practice a lot of role plays like as that, and you have to some look up the key points as well, so you can crack the interview as well. So further, I'm going to explain that. So formal mentorship program and coaching of reinforced product and application training and strengthen the sales skills. These are done for you know strengthen for the sales skills. So job shadowing with the sales engineers from offices around the country and joint sales call with customer sites. So basically, we have 4 offices in India exactly. So Chennai, Bangalore, Pune, and Gurgaon. So you have to go for like working with all other offices candidates as well to understand the market and the customer conditions as well. So another one is like corporate training programs are done, management development program, and continuous training and development. So our company is having you know their own philosophy of training and their own skills for the development program, and continuous hands-on training will be there given for the employees so that they have to come across the different you know according to market situation they have to groom themselves. That's it. So certificates programs for the relevant technologies. So inter-office shadowing opportunity for the top performance as well. So like internal competition is conducted in between the offices all over India, like, and you know what I can say, your performance is counted in the meetings and all. So operation in pandemic. So basically, pandemic is a major drawback that Indian current economy is faking right now. So it has hit the major companies, like not only like small companies, it has hit the big companies as well, players in the market. So our company was also hit through the due to this pandemic. Basically, 2 months there was like no business for the company. So and like how we did overcome. So basically, salesperson job is to visit the customer. So you have to be keep on traveling. You have to keep on the customer place. You have to keep on showing your product or have a discussion with that. So this pandemic, you know, have you know led us for the zero traveling. So what we have come across is like virtual calls. So basically, we used to visit the customers. We came across with the virtual calls. So like Zoom calls, Microsoft Teams, or any other thing. So having a visual call with the customer, you know, building a relation in that way. And key advantage. So one of the factor will be your key advantage of the company. So that one you have to trigger. Basically, it's like in this pandemic, you know, transport facility is not there, and like other facilities like support wise and like delivery wise, so whatever it may be. So you have to pick up a key advantage of your company and you have to trigger on that. So basically, it's like what happens is now our company is like a transport facility is very good. So logistics and all we can very quick as compared to others. So we are going to take that one as advantage and going to target the customers on that behalf. So promotional demos to new customers. So basically, when we are going to visit some of the customers who might be not available or something. So through this lockdown situation, even the customers were free. So like promotional demo or promotional promoting your product basically. So that will also help that also helped a lot actually, and like targeting companies and targeting key contacts. So our business is basically with a big business like a manufacturing industries like automobile manufacturing, food, pharma, other thing, like who are basically into manufacturing. So targeting companies. So basically we are targeting companies like automobile. So automobile sector is like very down in this pandemic. So food, pharma, essentials are like one of the, you know, booming industries in this pandemic actually. So we have targeting on that companies so that we can trigger our products like that. And targeting key contacts. Targeting key contacts is your business will help you to get the main contacts of the company. Like, you know, a managerial sector or like a plant head or something. Plant head is who is taking care of the overall organization in the production plant. So these are like you know, key points that we have focused to overcome this pandemic situation. So I'll just go with like what is B2B. So I'll just explain the concept. What is B2B? It refers to a situation where one business makes a commercial transaction with another. Typically occurs when one business is sourcing materials for their production process or service. So basically one business is making a transaction through a service or like product wise with the other company, with the other business. So this is called as B2B business. In terms of product, I can example is like an automobile company purchasing a forged metal component from the forging company. So, you know, automobile, basically a big vehicle is there. So that is an automobile. So in that, you know, there will be glass products will be there, engine components, wirings will be there, and like tires will be there, seating will be there. So these are all like completely not manufactured by one company. So they will be going to outsource or like they are going to give the orders for other companies. So like, you know, for example, like Maruti Suzuki. So Maruti Suzuki has having is like, you know, Minda, Tokarika Minda. So these are their suppliers. So basically they will be supplying, you know, headlights and Tokarika Minda is, you know, decasted parts. So these are like some of the fiber parts they are going to supply. So these are like B2B transactions. So in terms of service, how I can say, so normally you think yours is a food manufacturing company. So you have just started. So you don't have a lot of money to invest for the, like having your own accountancy department. So you are going to hire, you know, employing an auditing firm for your financial transaction. This is also a B2B transaction in general. So what is B2B model and B2C model? I'll just point out few differences. So in B2B model, the end user always is another business or the company. So in B2B model, like one business is having a transaction. So both business will be involved. So like one business having a dealing with other business. So in terms of B2C, the end user is a customer. Like me and you guys, you know, buying, you know, groceries or like automobiles from the showroom company or something like that. One business or company deals with another business company. So the dealing will happen in between the company to company. That's it. So here the products and services are actually the dealer or retailer or company or customer will be involved. So again, this transaction happened between two companies or transaction takes between company and the customer. That's it. So a few examples, I'll just go like. So you can just have a tire manufacturers selling tires to an auto company. So this automobile company will not manufacture their own tires except TVS. So they are going to outsource or they are going to buy from like MRF, C8 or JK Tire or something for their product actually. So supermarket buying items from the wholesalers. So you think you own you are running a supermarket. So you have to buy from a wholesaler or like directly company. This is actually a B2B transaction. And accounting firm servicing multiple companies. So I just explained now. A company offering intermediates to pharma company. So this one I can complete. So normally you think I'm going to manufacture some pharmacy related like vaccines or something. So I don't manufacture this packing related or like, you know, cans or bottles or something. So the pharma company is going to outsource under the other company. So they are going to supply, you know, the caps or bottles, what is the small for the capsule bottles. So this is actually a B2B transaction. So in terms of job profile, I will just explain what are the advantages or what are the disadvantages that we are coming across. So basically advantages, building contacts with managerial level people. So B2B will be helping you in building many of the managerial level people contacts. So basically one example I can tell, you might be heard of this Tata Motors. So we have a manufacturing plant of Tata Motors in Dharwad. So I have meet to the this what we call South Zone General Manager of this company. So it's like a company you are going to represent on behalf of your company. So you're the managerial people also will be normally friendly to you. So you can build a relation with them. And traveling, I can say it is one of the best advantage that is B2B is having or sales profile is having. So one example I will tell. So basically our office is in Bangalore. So we have places all over the market. We take care of Andhra Pradesh. We take care of in Bangalore office. We operate Andhra Pradesh or northern part of Karnataka. So monthly once or twice, we have to go to that place through flights or something what are the feasible transport modes. So traveling, so most of the people love traveling or who don't want the desk jobs. For them, I'm going to tell this B2B is a B2B or sales profile is very good for them. So they can meet new customers, they can have multiple contacts, and traveling is one of them. So another thing is monetary benefit I can tell is you can get good allowances as well. So this is my personal point of view, what I have gone, what I'm telling to you. So good allowances, you will be telling traveling allowances or if you're going to outstation farther from 300 kilometers plus. So you're going to get outstation allowances or overday allowances. Some of the allowances depends on the company. So getting to know different types of business. So basically, normally you can think I'm working as a sales associate in some of the radio company, comparatively it's the Radio City. So I'm going to sell the advertisement slots. Okay, I'm going to contact different types of customers who are existing customers as well as I have to contact the new customers. So you might go to visit them and you might get to know that what are the different types of businesses they are and how they are operating. So this will be helping you in this creating this entrepreneurship ideas. So you might think in a very different way. Okay, this might be it can be done in this way. You can start your own business. So getting the business ideas is also very a key point in the sales profile. So business needs. So you will get to know what are the business needs are there. So what are the business requirement documents, you have to get this license from this government and you have to get the municipal license or you have to get the whatever the industrial plant is there, you have to get their license. So these are the needs of the business to get start. You'll be getting to know that and it will be easy for you to start your own business as well. So business perspective. So business perspective is what your business is necessity, what it requires. Basically, I'm running a business. So I want a HR department or finance department or operations department. So different types of departments in your organization. So you want to start. So this one also you can easily figure out. So it will be helping you in your future. And the more you sell, the more you make. So in some of the companies, the sales will be, on behalf of so if this much number of quantities or this much service you do sell, so you'll be getting some commission or something like that on the basis of percentage. So this one is also very good point. The more you sell, the more you make. And negotiation. So, different people will be having different styles of, convincing skills or negotiation skills. So the customer's mindset is also different. So you can try to learn a very good negotiation. So it will be helping you in your further business if you are going to do or if you become an entrepreneur or if you start a business, it will be helping you very lot. So negotiation in terms of monetary or however you take negotiation skills and people skills is understanding the people's behavior. I might be very difficult to handle or negotiate, or like some people may be very easy to get negotiated. So you can learn the people skills as this. So as I said, getting to know the different types of businesses will lead to the entrepreneurship ideas as well. So advantages, where there are pros, there are cons. So disadvantages, I'm going to tell now, some of the few, I'll just tell what I have come across. Extensive traveling. So basically extensive traveling means, so you have to travel a lot. So in per day, you will be having some of the targets to visit these many customers. You have to visit these many companies. So this is also one of the drawback of this. Like most of the people, are maybe fed up of traveling, or like traveling leads to difficulty in managing personal life as well. So these are all of the rest. The leads are less. So sometimes what happens is, the leads that you are going to get are very less. So normally you might be having some of the telemarketing team, so though who are going to get the leads, or they might only contact you. So these are very limited, who are regular to that business, giving regular business, only you will be getting that leads. Rather than that, you have to pitch your own and you have to target your own customers. And pricing can be very difficult. So pricing can be very difficult. How? So I am going to sell. So you consider you have 5 to 6 companies you are going to sell. One company is different from another. So one company may procure at one shot, this much is the charge, okay, you buy it. And another company will ask for the discounts or something. So, tackling that situation is very difficult for this. So I have told us the pricing can be very difficult. You need to be highly motivated for this. Sales job is an evergreen job until you are highly motivated. So motivation skill should be very high for this. So because you are going to get very extensive traveling, or customer response as well, sometimes it will be negative, or customers, sometimes he might be aggressive. So you have to go through these scenarios as well. The less you sell, the less you earn. So it is vice versa of this, the more you sell, the more you earn. And customer relations. So building a customer relations is very advantage as well as very disadvantage as well. So if you build a customer relations very friendly, or have a good relation, so he might ask for more concession in price, or more discounts as well. Or it might be helping you in, directly selling, okay, you are understanding your relationship. Okay, sir, we will buy it, he might say. So this is also one of the thing. Target and pressure. So most of the companies will be having a target, and you will be getting a pressure from your superior level managers as well. So this one also you have to deal with. So most of all, target will be very high, because in this situation, you have to sell more to get the business for the company. So the targets will be more, and the pressure will also always be more. Convincing take more time actually. So some of the customer, it might take around 15 months or 1.5 year. Or 1 month also you can day, or you can just close in 1 day. So depends. Convincing the you, how you approach to the customer. In my company, we have done applications 2 years back, and we have received the sales after 2 years or something. These kinds of instances I have come across. So I'll just go further with the career opportunities, what you are going to get in sales profile. So starting from the sales. So sales associate, sales engineer, business development, etc., all are the same. So just the names are different. So after this, there will be certain targets or something, certain criteria. After you clear that, you will be a senior associate. Then you will be a team leader, area sales manager, regional sales manager, assistant manager, and the head will be general manager. Okay, career opportunities in other terms, you'll be having logistics department, finance department. In logistics department, you'll be for the material handling, or auditing, in material auditing will be there. So that will be done in logistics department. Finance department is financial aspects account receivables, account payables, those things. In marketing, there will be three different things will be there. One thing is telemarketing, social media marketing, and outdoor marketing. So telemarketing is like normally you will be know, like you'll be getting calls for this like credit cards and all. So over the phone you are getting the marketing will be done. Social media marketing, you always know, like, you know, so Facebook or like YouTube or anything, social media marketing. So outdoor marketing is basically, you know, conducting in a certain location, you know, conducting a trade fairs or something. So there also outdoor marketing is done basically. And administration operational is like general affairs, analyst job, data analyst, financial analyst, those kind of job. And IT information technology will be also there in some company, and human resource at that. So I'll be telling you some of the skills so that you have to go have in if you want to go to a sales company. So one thing is you have to be extrovert. In extroverts is like, you know, like you'll be knowing the what is the meaning of extrovert. You have to speak a lot. You have to make you have to initiate for everything. And interpersonal skills are like, you know, inside you having a self-confidence, proper way of speaking, or like just you can say how bold you are. And negotiation skills, you have to learn a lot of negotiation skills that will be helping you, you know, conduct the sales or like get the sales. And having a proper communication skills, communication skills is like how you approach to the customer. So some of the special skill is there, I'm going to tell in the further slide. So that will be coming under communication skills as well. Psychological factors as well. You have to consider psychological factors. So some customers will be very arrogant, very polite. Some will be very polite. So you have to consider that as well in the, you know, communication, or you have to deal according to that. So if the customer is arrogant, you have to be obeying, like always be obeying. Okay, sir, you have to request them. So sometimes, or like people who are polite, you can have a normal conversation with them. So local language is also one of the advantage of this, you know, getting to know the local advantage, you know, in India, actually local people will give you a lot of respect if you are knowing a local language. So this will also help you a lot. High motivation, as I said, you know, you have to have a high motivation. You have to not lose the hope. If you lose the hope, then it's like you end of your career in sales. Persuasion. So persuasion is like, how I can say, normally if you are going to enter a company, you are getting a lead. Okay, this customer is requiring that, you have got a lead. So how you are going to approach the customer, how you are going to follow up, and how you are converting that lead into sales. This is also, this whole process comes in the process, persuasion. So you have to be get a hold on that, how to approach and how to follow up and how to get the sales. And convincing sales, you know, how you convince the customer. This convincing skill, I'll explain in next point actually. So special skills. So after joining Keyence, I have come across with these three special skills. One thing is probing. So I think most of them might be not what is probing. Probing is like, you know, asking questions and getting the information from the customer. You know, like information like why he is needing, what is the budget he is having, and what is his requirement, what are the problems he is facing, like that. So normally, I'll tell a example. So consider A person as a customer and B person as a sales engineer or salesperson. So A customer goes to the mobile shop and he asks for a very good looking phone. So now B asks, okay, sir, like what kind of phone you are looking into? He will be asking, okay, so like any specific brand you are into. So if A person says iPhone, okay, he want to like ask, like B person will be asking, sir, like why only iPhone? You have like a better features in Android or something. So A person sells, he's a brand conscious, like he love to have, you know, have like an iPhone holding in his hand. So this is the gain behind need. So A person is like, he's brand conscious, so he want to go for the iPhone. So the B, the salesperson, he want to know the basically the need behind need. So this is called a probing process. So you are getting the information from that. And like second point, what I explained is like need behind need. So I explained the need behind need as well. The A customer is like, He's a brand conscious and added value. So when you got to know the need behind need, so you are going to explain the added value of that. So iPhone is like this, so it is like very stylish and it is very safe and very handy, or something like additional features you tell. So added value of that, so that you can easily place a, you know, that phone in the customer's, like, okay, the customer should buy it, and this will be helping in your negotiation and fixing the pricing as well. So these are like some of the points. So like further is like this is the end from my side. Like any questions you are having? Hello.
Aftab?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Yeah, you have done with the session?
Yes.
Yeah. So, guys, please raise your questions. Please raise your question. If you have any questions about the how to recruit at present pandemic situation, how anyone wants to get into the sales or marketing, specifically B2B companies. Guys, am I audible first of all? Okay.
Okay, ma'am, shall I continue? I have few more points to add.
Yeah, sure, please.
Okay, guys, like normally, if you are attending a sales interview for a sales job, basically interviewer will be having, like, you know, some interviewer will be having, you know, specific knowledge they are looking into. And like specific interviewers will be just, you know, asking about the company or like the basic details, and they might end up that. So I'll just tell you, if they are looking into certain situation. So one thing I have wondered is how long you will take up to catch the speed. So one thing is, like, normally I have given your product to sell. So how fast you will opt on that? Okay, you'll be given certain timings. So you have given 1 minute or something. So you have to, like, think properly in that 1 minute, and like you have to act on it very quickly. So this will also one of the criteria the interviewer will be looking into. And like if you have a experience, you most of the, you know, engineering, after that you have done a job, or like if you have experience, as it will be a matter. So if you have experience, they might be asking, like, do you have any contacts in the industry? So basically, if you have any contacts, or like you can tell. Otherwise, if you don't have, you have to tell them a criteria how you can get the plan for this, like you can get the contacts. And it's like another one thing, like they will ask, how do you present yourself in front of clients? So if you are representing a company, so they will ask the questions like, how do you represent a company in front of a client? And another one thing is, like, they will check, are you a self starter? And as, like, in that presentation skills. So they will consider, like, these all the criteria when you are going to a sales job. So these are the aspects that you have to look in if you are going to for a sales interview or something.
Guys, any questions? With respect to recruitment and the skills, interviews, whether you are looking for what type of skills you need to be loaded with while before attending any interviews and all. Okay, fine then. So I hope you are finished. Anything you want to add upon after?
Yeah. I just add upon, like, I think my contact details are displaying on your screen.
Yeah.
So if you have any doubt, if you have any query on these sessions, or like if you are the career guidance, or like if you are having a jumble session, like where you want to go for, like, for which specialization you want to opt to. So no problem, you can have a contact with me. Ma'am, as this, my contact details are visible on your screen.
Yeah, it's clear.
Fine. So you can just contact me through LinkedIn, WhatsApp, or Instagram, or like a mail, or any kind of thing.
Okay, fine. So as a part of, so you have concluded your session, Aftab?
Yes, ma'am, yes.
Yeah, so basically with respect to your sharing of views and information, the session was very informative after, because not only you have spoke about the theory concepts and all, practically how your company is doing, and you have included all the skills which are needed to go through the, any interview and to carry the sales job or marketing job, any kind of specialization, and with respect to the proper designation to be carried out at particular organization or corporate level, covering all the levels of skill set, like take an example of negotiation skills, interview skills, interpersonal skills, communication skills, and so on. So it was very nice session, and with your busy schedule, you have given a time for us. That is a big thing for us. So always wish to have in your session. So I request Colonel Prasanna sir to give a conclusion remark for the session. Guys, please go through the chat box. There is a feedback session. Please fill up the forms. And next thing is covered by Prasanna sir.
Right. Good morning, all the participants. And good morning, Aftab. Very good to see you. Well, I say with a little bit of pride that Aftab was one of the first few students, first session that I took in this college. And I'm really proud to see Aftab today doing well. And very kind of him to have spared time for our other students, that is his junior batch. And then, of course, the new batch that came when he had reached third semester. So the first semester people at that time are now passing out, and we have another batch. Those people won't have met Aftab, but I'm really happy that Aftab has been able to spare some time and talk to our students, talk to us, give us some insights on his experiences while in the process of recruitment, as well as in his initial years of the career. I wish him all the luck, and we wish our students all the luck in their placement drives. I'm sure these tips that he has given will be helpful. I once again thank you, Aftab, on behalf of the director, all the faculty members, and the students of our MBA program. And we look forward to meeting you sometime when you come down this side towards the campus. Do look us up, meet us. We'll be very happy to catch up in person. And wish you all the very best in your future and your career as well. Thank you so much. And thank you very much, Tejaswini ma'am, for conducting this. Goodbye and take care.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you very much for this opportunity. I would like to thank Tejaswini ma'am, as like our Prasanna sir, like all other faculties, like who have taught us very well to cope up the situation, like how you are, how maybe the situation you have to cope up. So that skills have been come from our like our lecturers. I would like to thank each and everyone who had helped me to come up till here situation. Thank you.